may say I'm leaping to conclusions, but you're not completely happy, are you? It's Mother, isn't it?
No, it is not.
You're brooding over her death, aren't you?
Hey, for the final time, your mother is not dead. She's run off with your Uncle Henry.
Dear Father, I know you only say such things to comfort me.
Your mother is alive and well and living in Droitwich. It's not her I brood over. I'm sad because, my darling, our poverty has reached such extremes that I can no longer afford to keep us. I must look to my own dear, tiny darling to sustain me in my frail dotage.
But Father, surely...
Yes, Kate. I want you to become a prostitute.
Father!
Do you defy me?
Why, indeed I do. For it is better to die poor than to live in shame and ignominy.
Oh, no, it isn't.
I'm young and strong and clever. My nose is pretty. I shall find another way to earn us a living.
Oh, please go on the game. It's a steady job. And you'd be working from home.
Goodbye, Father. I shall go to London, disguise myself as a boy, and seek my fortune.
Why go all the way to London when you can make a fortune lying on your back?
Thank you, Baldrick.
Sorry I'm late.
Don't bother, Torres. Apologising, I'm sorry you're alive.
No, so the target's ready. I'd like to see the Spaniard if he make his way past me.
Well, go to Spain, there are millions of them.
No, I advise him to stay there then, keep their hands off our women.
Oh, God, who is she this time?
I don't know what you mean. Ah, no. Oh!
Ah! And who is Jane?
I have sworn to secrecy. Torture me, kill me, you shall never know. Oh, Jane Harrington!
Ah.
We're very much in love, my lord.
This is the Jane Harrington.
Yes.
Jane, bearing in a Y-shaped coffin, Harrington.
I think perhaps there are two Jane Harringtons.
No, tall, blonde, elegant.
Aye, that's her.
Goes like the privy door when the plague's in town.
My lord!
Go on, get on with your shot. You'll get over it. Are you? It's only Baldrick, actually. See, she's got this thing about beards, apparently.
Well, in that case, I'm going to shave.
Poor old Pete Rain, eh? Never catch me falling in love, that's for damn sure as mustard. Come in.
You look like Edda.
Ah, good day to you. Boy. What is it brings you here?
I'm an honest, hard-working lad, but poor, and I must support my father who is stark, raving mad. Therefore, I've come to London to seek a servant's wage.
Ah, yes indeed, but unfortunately I already have a servant.
The word is... Your servant is the worst servant in London.
Yes, that's true. Baldrick, you're fired. Be out of the house in 10 minutes. Well, my boy, you've got yourself a job. What do they call you?
Kate.
Isn't that a bit of a girl's name?
Oh, it's short for Bob.
Bob?
Yes.
Well, Bob. Welcome on board. Sorry, Baldrick, any reason you're still here?
I've got nowhere to go, my lord.
Oh, surely you'll be allowed to starve to death in one of the royal parks.
But I've been in your service since I was 2½, my lord.
Well, that must be why I'm so utterly sick of the sight of you.
Can't I stay here and do the same job but for no wages?
Well, you know where you'd have to live.
In the gutter?
Yes. And you'd have to work a bit harder, too.
Of course, my lord.
All right, then. Go and get Bob's stuff in and chuck your filthy muck out into the street.
God bless you, sweet master.
Now then, Bob.
Hiya.
to love her tricks and sports and all sorts of rosy joke caperings. More besides, I want to get a young scum.
Thank you so much for letting me stay.
Not at all, Bob. I'm looking forward to having you. Having another man about the house instead of that animal, Baldrick. Excuse me, I'm just going to the lavatory.
How little he knows and how much I would have him know.
I see, Bob. This calls a celebration. How about a game of cup and ball and a slap of tea at Mrs. Biggin's pie shop?
Get lost, creep.
I like you, Bob. You've got balls.
Impersonation of Columbus.
That doesn't surprise me. He used to laugh at those people with the funny faces and the bells.
Lepers, Mark.
No. Yes, that's right.
Yes, isn't it? Speaking of leprosy.
What's happened these days?
Well, the whisper on the underground grapevine, Mark, that Lord Blackett spent all his time with a young boy in his service. Surely not, Mum.
You almost were a boy, my little cherry pit. What? Oh, yes. Out you popped, out your mummy's pumpkin, and everyone was shouting, it's a boy, it's a boy. And then somebody said, but it hasn't got a winkle. And then I said, a boy without a winkle. God be praised, it's a miracle, a boy without a winkle. And then Sir Thomas More, he pointed out that a boy without a
well, you seem as a very perceptive man, Sir Thomas More.
What has happened to Edmund? There's something very odd about someone who spends all their time with a servant.
Well, Bob, we're a couple of fine lads together, aren't we? Let's get ratted and talk about girls, eh? Oh, yes, we can sing some really dirty songs and... I find you curiously pleasant company, young Bob.
I'm honoured, and for my part, I've nothing more than to be with you, old man.
Well, yes, there's nothing more healthy and normal than having a good chum.
What do you, my lord, of love?
You mean rumpy pumpy?
What would you say, my lord, if I was to say to you, I love you?
It would depend entirely on who you said it to. I mean, if you said it to a horse, I presume you were sick. If you said it to Baldrick, I presume you were blind. And if you said it to me, well...
Yes, my lord?
Well, I'd naturally assume you were having a big lad's joke about rat ticklers the way we healthy fellows often do, and I'd probably grab you for a friendly wrestle, and we'd probably slap each other's sides like jolly good chums and laugh at... That's what it really would be like if we really did fancy each other.
In that case, my lord, I love you.
Don't worry, Bob. He used to try and kill me too.
Baldrick, thank God you're here. What do you want?
Well, sir, I was wondering whether I could sleep on the roof, because the town bailiff says if I sleep in the gutter, I'll get swept into the Thames with the rest of the turds.
Of course, Baldrick. Help yourself. I was just off to bed, anyway. Good night, Baldrick. Good night, Bob.
Good night, my lord.
Yes.
Oh, God.
My man servant.
I see. Well, don't be embarrassed.
another servant.
I see. What's wrong with him?
There's nothing wrong with him. That's the trouble. He's perfect. And last night, I almost kissed him.
I see. So you've started fancying boys then, have you?
Not boys, a boy.
Yes, well, it's not split hairs. It's all rather disgusting. And naturally, you're worried.
Of course I'm worried.
Well, of course you are. It isn't every day you wake up to discover you're a screaming bender with no more right to live on God's clean earth than a weasel. Ashamed of yourself?
Not really, no.
Bloody hell, I would be. Still, just these little rampant totty for us real men, eh?
Look, am I paid for this personal abuse or is it extra?
No, all part of the service. I think you're in luck, though. An extraordinary new cure has just been developed for exactly this kind of sordid problem.
It wouldn't have anything to do with leeches, would it?
I had no idea you were a medical man.
I know about anything you doctors didn't try to cure with leeches. A leech on my ear for earache. A leech on my bottom for constipation.
They're marvellous, aren't they?
Well, the bottom one wasn't. I just sat down and squashed it.
Was on the highest authority.
Yes, I heard that. Dr. Hoffman of Stuttgart, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, that's right. The great Hoffman.
Owner of the largest leech farm in Europe.
Yes. Well, I'm a busy man. I can't spend all day gossiping. As far as this case is concerned, Blackadder, I've had time to think it over, and I can strongly recommend a course of
leeches. Yes, just pop a couple down a codpiece before I go to bed.
No, don't be ridiculous. It's in the Dark Ages. Pop four in your mouth in the morning and let them dissolve slowly. In a couple of weeks, you'll be beating your manservant with a stick, just like the rest of us.
You're just an old quack, aren't you?
Yes, well, I'd rather be a quack than a ducky.
Charges are enormous considering you find these things in a puddle. Oh, there's a thought, Baldrick. When's your mother next coming to visit?
I don't know, my lord. She's not been in touch since you put that ferret up her smock on your last birthday.
Ah, yes.
And the rabbit. Your guests thought she'd been possessed by demons.
Yes, well, at least they didn't talk to her. She had the social grace of a cart horse with wind. And a smell. Still, if we invited your entire herd of obnoxious relatives round to stay, I wouldn't need another prescription for a month.
Well, would you prefer this fat spider I found in the bath? I was saving it for myself, but...
Oh, shut up, Baldrick. I don't eat invertebrates for fun, you know. This is doctor's orders.
Oh, I don't hold with all this doctoring. If I need any doctoring, I go to the wise woman.
Yes, Baldrick. I'm long past entrusting myself to some deranged druid who gives her professional address as One Dunhill Mansions, Putney. Tell me, young crow, is this Putney?
That's it, B! That's it, B!
Yes, it is, not that it be. You don't have to talk in that stupid voice to me. I'm not a tourist. I seek information about a wise woman.
The wise woman. The wise woman.
Yes, the wise woman.
Two things, my lord, must ye know of the wise woman.
Yes.
First, she is a woman.
Wise.
You do know her, then?
No, just a wild stab in the dark, which is incidentally what you'll be getting if you don't start being a bit more helpful. Do you know where she lives?
Of course.
Where?
Here. Got an appointment?
No.
I'm going anyway.
Thank you, young crow. Here is a purse of monies, which I'm not going to give to you. Hello. No, it's much worse than that. I'm in love with my manservant.
Oh, well, I'd sleep with him if
What?
When I fancy people, I sleep with them. Oh, I have to drug them first, of course, being so old and warty.
But what about my position, my social life?
Very well. Two other paths are open to you. Three cunning plans to cure their ailments.
Oh, good.
The first is simple. Kill them.
Never.
Then try the second. Kill yourself.
And the third?
The third is to ensure that no one else ever knows.
Ah, that sounds more like it. How?
Kill everyone in the whole world.
Now listen here, Bob. I've got something very important to say to you, and I want you to listen very carefully.
Yes?
Look, Bob. I have decided that you are to leave my service.
Oh, no, my lord. My father will starve, and I have to become a male prostitute. And besides, I thought we were friends.
Well, we are friends, Bob. Of course. In fact, that's the reason I want you to leave my service and become my living chum.
Oh, my lord!
Now, I want to make it absolutely clear I'm in no way interested in the contents of your tights.
You might be, my lord, if you knew what I kept in them.
I flatter myself, Bob, that I know what a gentleman keeps in his tights. Thank you very much.
But, my lord, I have a great secret.
What?
Prepare to be amazed.
Oh, God, you've got a birthmark shaped like a banana, haven't you?
No.
Or a tattoo saying, get it here.
No.
Oh, my God, you've got a belly button that sticks outwards, haven't you?
No, my lord.
Then what can it possibly be? Good lord. So, what was all that Bob stuff about then?
Because you wouldn't just use me and cast me aside like you have so many women before.
Would I?
Yes. But now you've had a chance to photograph me for who I really am.
Yes, that's true. And now, I want to marry you.
Kate?
Then come. Kiss me, Kate.
I've been grave intelligence of your former favourite, Lord Blackadder.
Oh, good.
It appears he wishes to marry a girl called Bob.
To wed.
So I'm here. Archie, what do you make of all this?
But I must profess that I'm astonished that Lord Blackadder has eyes for any other woman than yourself.
Good point. They're slightly grovelly.
Ah, yes, ma'am. But when I fell in love, I did not know she was a woman. I thought she was a boy.
Well, that makes it perfectly acceptable, doesn't it?
Oh, all right. Go on and marry her.
Thank you, ma'am.
Very nice now, wouldn't it?
No, ma'am.
I
lordship that your maid of honour should be a man.
Thank you very much, my lord.
Well, I use the word man in its broadest possible sense. For as we all know, God made man in his own image. It'd be a sad lookout for Christians around the globe if God looked anything like you, Baldrick.
Ignore old Mr. Grumpy. You look sweet as a little pie.
Kate, he looks like what he is, a dung ball in a dress.
Oh, Edmund, I am...
You didn't tell me you were expecting guests. You're such a pretty one, too. Well, you're a little cute to be hiding yourself away all these years. Tell me, gorgeous, what's your name?
He's called Baldrick.
Baldrick. That's a pretty name. Edmund used to have a servant called Baldrick.
Put away such small talks, lady. A kiss.
What?
And so modest, too. Got a little tease? You know you want to.
Oh, all right, then.
Original perfume.
That is Aunt Baldrick. He's wearing a dress. Anyway, what do you want?
Well, Edmund, there has been some discussion in the court about the subject of your best man, and I thought the time had come to bring the matter to its conclusion.
Ah, yes, Percy. I would like you...
Oh, I'm so proud!
Please, let me finish. I would like you to take this letter to Dover, where is recently docked the galleon of my old school friend and adventurer, Lord Flashheart. He shall be my best man.
Lord Flashheart? The best sword, the best shot, the best sailor, the best kisser in the kingdom.
Even he. To Dover at once.
Actually, I was going to suggest Lord Flashheart the best man myself.
Bye.
Oh, Edmund, I can't believe it's really happening.
It is, my sweet.
Before we go in, I'd like to meet my father.
Oh, father. Excuse me. Could you move along, please? Look, I'm waiting for my father-in-law. The last thing I want is some scruffy old beggar bluffing up the corridor smelling of cabbage.
I am your father-in-law.
Oh, no. All right. How much do you want to clear off?
Edmund, he's my father, my only living relative.
10 pounds should do the trick.
Father!
All right, there you go.
Edmund, you mustn't.
Oh, don't worry. I'll get Baldrick to beat him up after the ceremony. We'll get the money back. Come on, we're late.
Ah, Edmund, can I get on with you, thing? I want to get to the reception so I can get swiftly and seduce someone.
Ah, yes, ma'am, but unfortunately, my best man still does not arrive.
Can you remember one?
Well, there's no one else I can really think of. Sorry, Percy?
Nothing, my lord. Just clearing my throat.
Well, I suppose I could ask Percy. Percy!
My lord!
Can you think of another best man?
Well, one name does spring to mind.
Yes, but I can't ask Baldrick. He's a bridesmaid. And besides, I need a friend, an equal, an old and trusty companion.
I think there is someone in the room who fits that description.
Of course! Nursey, how do you fancy putting on a pair of hose and being my best man?
Edmund, don't be so naughty.
All right, I'm sorry. Melt it. All right. Ashamed as I am, and contradiction in terms though it is, Percy, you can be the best man.
Oh, what an honour! Noble cause! A Baltimore ring, and...
I really did think old Flash would have turned up, though.
Hooray!
Where have I been?
Where have you been?
fella. Can't take the pace of the ignorant. And Queenie. You look sexy. The way you hair on. I prefer it that way.
Got such a crush on him.
And Melchie! Still worshipping God, I see? The last thing I heard, he started worshipping me. Ha ha! And Nursie. I like it firm and fruity. Am I pleased to see you? Have I just put a canoe in my pocket? Down, boy, down! Now, where's this amazing bird? The one that's got my old palette. Doing exactly whatever he likes. 10 times a night.
Ah, yes, sir. Blush, I'd like you to meet Kate, my...
Hey, baby. Mm, 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 mm. She's got a tongue like an electric eel and she likes the taste of a man's tonsils. You don't want to marry this jerk, baby. Meet me on my horse here. 8 seconds.
But I can't really struck. You see, I actually found I prefer wearing boys' clothes.
Weird! I always feel more comfortable in a dress. I've got a plan, and it's as hot as my pants.
What a man flashes, eh? Things will soon change now he's back. Won't they, Pat?
So long, suckers. If you ever get bored with your lives, give me a call and I'll come round and kill you.
Goodbye, Edmund, and thanks for everything.
Hooray!
Which we had a beard.